Welcome to another food adventure with Getting Lost. Today we're at Kebun Baru Mall to visit this place, which has an interesting design called Kebun Baru Food Center because of this and this and of course this too. So join me at this uniquely designed food center to eat. Let's start with how to get there. First of all, from Ang Mo Kio MRT station, which is on the north-south line. Once you get out of the gantry, you head straight. When you head straight, you'll notice there's a escalators going down on your right. So you would take the escalator going down and keep going down until you reach the bottom of the escalator. At the bottom, you just keep continue going straight. Follow the tunnel. The exit we are looking for is actually exit C, C for China. And if you keep walking straight at the end of the tunnel, at the flight of the stairs, this is exit C. Exit C will take you to Ang Mo Kio Hub and also to Ang Mo Kio Bus Interchange. As you keep walking straight, you'll notice there's two flights of escalators going up. Take the first flight of escalator going up. Okay, and the escalator go up until you reach the top. And now you're at Ang Mo Kio Bus Interchange. Okay, so the Ang Mo Kio Bus Interchange actually is beside Ang Mo Kio Hub, which is actually a shopping center. So a bus interchange in Singapore is actually a place where all the buses will wait, will come and pick up passengers, and also will, when they are not operating, they also will be parking out in the interchange, and you just keep walking until you find your bus that you're going to take, which is for us, bus 262. Okay, as you can see coming right up, at berth B4 is bus 262. So you join the line, join the queue, wait for the bus to come, and when the bus come, you get on the bus. And here we are on the bus itself. The bus, after it leaves the bus interchange, you travel along Ang Mo Kio Avenue 8, and basically you just continue sitting on the bus. And this bus itself will continue on until the end of Avenue 8, and then it will turn right to Avenue 1, and it will continue along Avenue 1. The stop that we are going to get off at is actually along Avenue 1, and we also will notice that Ang Mo Kio Avenue 1 is actually a boundary road that actually separates Bishan from Ang Mo Kio, and in between this boundary road is actually the Bishan Ang Mo Kio Park, and the Bishan Ang Mo Kio Park actually runs along Ang Mo Kio Avenue 1, and the bus stop that we are going to get off at is actually 8 bus stops from the bus interchange. Here is the bus stop along Ang Mo Kio Avenue 1 that you are supposed to get off at. And once you see this bus stop, you should actually get off the bus, which is the, as I repeat again, the 8th bus stop from the bus interchange. Okay, so once you get off on the bus, you you just continue heading straight. There's actually a, like I told you earlier, the Bishan Ang Mo Kio Park beside you, and you're actually walking under a covered walkway. So just keep walking along the covered walkway until you reach a overhead bridge. Basically, Ang Mo Kio Avenue 1 is actually a busy road, so I do not advise you to try to jaywalk it. So please use the overhead bridge to cross. So you climb up to the bridge until you reach the top. You turn right. Okay, and walk across the bridge until you reach the other side. Then you turn right again, and then now you let gravity take you and help you to walk down the bridge. Walk down the stairs. Okay, so once you cross the road, okay, you keep heading straight. Okay. And as you're heading straight, you notice there's also another bus stop opposite here. You can, after you eat, take this bus stop, take back bus 262 back to the interchange. But before that, just keep heading straight and keep walking along the pathway. And next to the pathway is actually a block here, a residential HDB block. So you turn left here, and I want you to walk under the block. Okay, just keep walking under the block. Okay, so you just keep walking under the block. And if you notice, right in front of you, there's actually some tentage, because in front of us is actually a temple. Okay, this temple itself is the Chua A Pho Temple, and it's one of the nicely and traditionally designed temples in Singapore. So previously they actually had a festival here, and that's why there's a tentage. Anyway, we are going to walk beside the temple, and this temple is actually quite impressive without the tentage. But at the moment, because of tentage, you can't really see much. But we're just going to walk beside the or past the temple, and you keep walking up here under the covered walkway. And in front of you, you will actually see Kebun Baru Market. And after Kebun Baru Market is Kebun Baru Food Center. And so we have reached the location that we are at. We have reached Kebun Baru Food Center, and let's see what should we eat first. So the first thing we will try here is from this store called Tiki Cooked Food. This is a store that sells cooked food, from the name itself, I guess. But what a lot of people order from them is their noodle soup. Yeah, I think that's right. Soup noodles. Okay. Here is the bowl of noodle soup itself. Basically, the soup is served to you piping hot. It's very flavorful broth, but they do use a bit of MSG in the soup itself. And the noodles are quite nice and chewy. They also have a bit of pork lard, and also pieces of meat, and then you also have the egg, which I'm mixing it into the noodles now. So you will have minced pork, and then you have some vegetables, maybe some lettuce, and then you also have some fish ball, which once you chew into them, they actually disappear. You have some fish cake, and then you also have, which I find quite nice into this dish here, is actually liver. The liver actually goes quite well with the noodles, and the noodles is actually quite tasty. It actually reminds me a bit of eating instant noodles, except that you're actually using real ingredients. You use proper noodles, proper, you put in real meat, you put in fish balls, you put in fresh vegetables instead of any dehydrated stuff. So those people who like instant noodles will love this. Next up is Hong Keng Beef Noodle Soup and Laksa. This is a shop that sells beef noodles and also laksa beef noodles, which is slightly different. I didn't actually try the mixed beef laksa, but maybe next time I will try. But what I ordered instead is actually a dry beef noodles. And here's the noodles itself. So as a garnish, you have chives, you have some preserved vegetables, you also and then together you put in with mix beef pieces, and then you put on together mix it with noodles, which is the rice noodles, and then you put it mix it up all together with a starchy beefy sauce. Okay, so here we have some tendon, and then we have some beef pieces, we have some stomach, we have some sliced beef, and then we have some tripe here. So, and then maybe a fish ball, that's a fish ball there. Yep, there it is. So you're gonna mix it up all together, and overall, it's actually quite a tasty dish here. Not overly overpowering, but quite tasty. If you like beef noodles, this is a good example of beef noodles, and it's quite tasty. So if you like it, come and eat. Next up is another shop along with queues during lunchtime, which is Huang Fu Duck Rice. Okay, and here is the duck rice itself. One thing, if you're eating braised duck, the sauce that they pour on the duck itself goes very, very well with rice. You can just eat the sauce and rice together. And here they give you some duck meat on top, and of course the duck meat will go well together with the braising sauce. And what's surprisingly is the soup itself. The soup is quite delicious. And I think some people do ask for refills, but I don't know whether they will charge you for a refill. But overall, it's a very good duck rice. If you do like braised duck, come down here and try this. You won't be disappointed. But like I said, the braising sauce with the rice is really good. You can eat it all by itself. So this is the Kebun Baru Food Center. It's neatly designed, but beside the design, there's also some good food here. So please come down here and try. You won't regret it. And if you like what you see, please share, like, and subscribe. And the most important thing, don't forget to join me for my next food adventure.